What's going on, everybody? Sean Daniel here with a very special guest.
Hi, where's the camera?
That's right here, actually. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Oh, hey. My name is Andres Colin.
That's right. You may know him from Andreas and Sean fame, the Overcast video, the Stars video. Got an album out, which I'll link you to, so you can check it out. But I wanted to bring him here because this guy, aside from being my brother, he has what I consider the best one-man show I have ever seen in my life. And a lot of it is due to his mastery of the loop pedal and other devices. So I thought what we'd do today is kind of hook your board up and maybe just kind of like run through how you do it, how you do what you do to make those looping sounds. We'll have a demonstration at the end for everything.
Oh, perfect. Do you want me to go through every pedal, or do you want me to show you like how I do it?
Maybe just do a quick demonstration, and then we'll go through piece by piece what we got going on.
Quick demonstration, like
look. Sure, yeah, whatever, yeah.
All right. Well, basically, this is what I do. Watch this closely.
Short demonstration, but anyways, you get the idea. It's awesome. And I think what I really like about your setup is that you incorporate a lot of analog stuff into the pedal board, etc. too.
Yes, I'm a big fan of analog. I like to be able to I like to be able to control the stuff right away. If I'm at a gig, I like to be able to reach out real quick and adjust whatever I need to adjust. Digital is cool, sometimes to save presets and all that stuff.
Yeah. And you can do your own show from just like a looper pedal. You don't necessarily need to add like a microphone. Like the microphone is great because you can do hand percussion, like analog hand percussion and singing too, if that's your thing too.
Yes.
So anyways, why don't you run us through what you got going on here?
Yeah, sure. My pedal board is basically stuff I've been collecting throughout the years. I started just with a looper. That was the first thing I got and the only thing I had. I used to just do loops of my guitar and I used to do the percussion with my hands and the guitar. And then I eventually started getting other stuff. I realized there's a guitar that talks to a synthesizer.
Yeah, like probably the most important part, the most important component of the whole thing is the Godin Multiac.
Right. Yeah, this is a guitar that I love because it's feedback free. That's basically the reason I love it. You can play with a band and you can, turn it up and it won't give you as much feedback as a regular acoustic guitar.
You can say it's an acoustic electric, but honestly, it's an electric guitar that kind of sounds, you can play it acoustically or whatever. But the electric component, I think, is what makes it so.
Yeah, it's beautiful. And the sound of each pickup, instead of having one pickup, it has like the six pickups. And that separates the sounds going into the synthesizer. I use this Roland GR20, which is an old version of It's an older version of their synthesizers.
Right.
This is, I like this because I'm able to play other instruments with my guitar. I can play the saxophone, like. Actually, I have, hold on, there we go. Xylophone, and many other instruments.
It's beautiful. And the important thing to remember is not any guitar can do that if you plug it into a synthesizer. You need something with a compatible output. Correct. Like if you notice the cable that goes into there isn't just like a regular quarter inch cable.
Yeah, that's like a 13 pin connector.
13 pin connector, yeah.
So you have the ability, we can probably show this later, but
there are a couple guitars that do this.
Yeah, you have the ability to plug in a normal or the 13 pin which communicates to the synthesizer. So you're able to play the regular sound of the guitar or mute that, you know, and use a synthesizer sound.
Yeah.
And you can control it through here, too.
Roland also used to make a pickup that you could install on a guitar to kind of have that. I don't really have a lot of experience.
No, actually, yeah, they do. So you, basically, those are your choices. You can buy any electric guitar and buy an adapter that plugs into your electric guitar and communicates to the Roland. Or your other choice is to buy a guitar made to work with the Roland, which is this one. It's called Synth Access Guitars,
okay.
SA.
You know? Cool, sure.
Basically, that's it. Then I also have this, this is my looper. So the synthesizer goes to my looper. And I have a vocal effect.
Yep.
This I use for harmonies. You know, like,
yeah, maybe do that.
So I mean, some people don't like the harmonizers. Some people don't like the harmonizers and, it's just sometimes, you know, for I use it.
It can be overdone really easily.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I try to only use it at like one phrase, one couple words that I'm singing. Suddenly I throw a little bit of the harmonizer and it just adds a little to it. But I try not to overdo it, you know?
Exactly.
Because I also have the ability to record my own vocals with this other pedal that I have right here. This is a hot shot. It's an A-B switch. It's just an A-B switch. So I can reroute my vocal mic either to my loop, to my looper when I want to record the percussion or my voice, or I can route it to the board so I can be looping my guitar while singing, and if it's on the B, it's sending it to the board so it won't be looped.
Which is really important because the routing is so important. Because if you're looping a phrase that you're singing over, it's going to capture your voice in it and then it's going to loop your voice and you don't necessarily want that.
That's actually an issue, a very common issue with a lot of performers, with a lot of loopers. That's a big issue that they are recording the guitar and the ambience noise from the crowd gets recorded over and over.
Yeah.
Every time they do a phrase, they record the drums, then they record maybe the bass line. And every time they're recording the crowd and the noise. So eventually you hear all these noises and I hated that.
Or even just little things like hum.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like a 60 cycle hum or something like that will be in the loop.
Yeah, like the wind, stuck the air. You know, the air, the glass and all that stuff.
Or if an audience member coughs at a bar or something,
exactly.
That's in the loop.
Oh, even worse, a motorcycle passing by.
Oh my God.
Oh,
yeah,
that's the worst. But anyways, thanks to a friend of mine, Scott Kurtz, I was able to find the hot shot. He told me about it, where you can, it's just an A-B switch. So that way, now I can, every time I'm going to record just my guitar or a drum or something with my guitar, then I click on it and it reroutes my voice to the board, so now it won't record any of that.
Takes it out of the loop.
Yeah, nothing out of my microphone will be recorded, so it's like a very clean. I can loop 10 things with my guitar and it will be as clean as what do they say, as a whistle.
Something like that, yeah. It's a very famous saying. Yeah, so anyway, bare minimum, if you're into like looping and performing and stuff like that, you want a looper and a router, right?
I mean, well, that's just the way I do it. Some other loopers, they connect every single thing to their board, to the mixer, and then from the mixer, they come to the looper. I do a different setup.
Sure.
My setup, everything goes to the mixer, and then at the end, from the looper, one channel to the mixer. And then, like I said, with the A-B switch, another channel for the voice.
It's more of a hands-off thing. Sometimes if you have a mixer like within reach, you can kind of like mute channels and stuff like that.
It's just different ways, you know. One might be better than the other one. I'm not sure. I haven't tried the other way.
Sure.
Where I have
you
a mixer.
This is what you do. You
know? Yeah, this is how I do it. Mm-hmm. And I have the, I also have a very cool reverb. I like a lot my reverb.
Oh, for sure. It has a TC Electronic Hall of Fame.
Yeah, because without it, you know, it's just too dry. And then,
especially with nylon string.
Nylon, exactly. So, you know. Exactly. Actually, you might say that this is too much reverb, and yes, it is too much, but when you're soloing, it's kind of cool. You know, when you're doing, for example, it depends on what kind of song I'm playing. If I'm playing a rock, like an American rock song, like, or a song by the Red Hot Chili Peppers, something like that, then I barely use any. I almost use no reverb at all, you know, like. But if I'm playing like a flamenco song, you know, like,
provides such an ambience and such a space out of
exactly.
Nowhere.
Exactly. Reverb, I don't, a lot of performers keep a specific reverb and only use that one. No, I like to always, depending on the song, put more or less. You
especially
know?
When your loop is in the box, as they call it. Like, it's a digital loop. You're not getting any of the ambience of, like, the space you're in. It's pretty important.
Exactly. I like reverb. Some people don't even like reverb.
That's ridiculous.
A lot of performers don't even use reverb.
I love it. Come on.
There's never enough reverb. Anyways.
Oh, my gosh. If you see my videos, you know that my main reverb is, like, on, like, 9 o'clock.
That's funny. And then I have the... This is a brand new pedal. Another friend.
There
we go. Javi,
TC Electronic.
A good friend of mine.
Kind of
brand Javi. He recommended me this... Body Rest by TC Electronics. This is really, it really gives a very cool tone to my guitar. A very warm.
It enhances the electric. So one of my biggest issues with acoustic electrics is I never really like the electric output on acoustic electric. It always sounds super bright. You lose all the body of miking up an acoustic guitar.
Exactly, yeah.
But then in performing situations.
Especially with a semi-hollow guitar. Like,
sure.
This sounds great. This guitar sounds great, but it's a very specific sound. Mm-hmm. Not as warm and deep as a full body guitar.
Of course, yeah. But the issues with the full body guitar is feedback, especially when you're using with a looper into like a microphone. Feedback issues galore,
exactly.
Right? So this enhances the body of an electric output.
Yeah. So thing. Check this out.
There you go. There it is. It sounds more like a microphone amplified nylon string guitar with that.
Yeah,
let's
check it out.
That's cool. It's awesome.
It sounds like
a microphone with nylon string.
Exactly. Yeah.
There you go.
And you know, that's basically, I mean, it's very simple. I have this little thing here, which is just a Bluetooth receiver. So I can put a song on my break. Like, if I take a break, I put a song on my iPad and I can walk away with my iPad and the music keeps playing. It's convenient if I'm going to take my iPad. And then finally,
it's a custom-made
AB switch. So I can plug in a bass. I have an upright bass. It's cool.
Sometimes if a special guest comes to visit you during a show.
Exactly.
Patch them in there, you know?
Yeah.
There you go. So this is a Boss RC30 looper. You've tried a couple looping stations out, right? I think you used to have a digital.
Well, I bought the Boomerang, which some people use. And I couldn't figure it out because it's all digital. And I could have taken the time, but I was so used to this that I just went back to this. Mm-hmm. Eventually, I will probably try a different looper because I like to be able to record just a couple phrases.
Yeah, the limit there is the phrase switching.
So, for here, if I'm going to record 8 measures on my first loop, all my next loops will be the same amount of measures. So if I want to add a shaker or a bass line, I have to do the same amount of measures, which is limiting and sometimes...
Sure.
You know, the thing, so that's the only thing. That's why I keep my loops short. I try to keep my loops.
Other loopers have like a phrase multiplier.
Exactly.
That you can kind of like, okay, do 4 here, but you know you're going to, you know, multiply it to whatever the total phrase.
Exactly.
Ends up being. So anyways, I think that's kind of it.
Yeah, that's basically it. And another thing is the making a snake is very, you know, the snake, so you can run all your wires to the board.
Right,
it just makes it way cleaner. A lot of people leave all the wires.
Yeah.
Like maybe that's the look they're going for, but
this
for
is
me,
a super tight, compact pedal board, which I feel so inept because I had Justin here the other day, and his pedal board is like a work of art. This is like the ultimate, like, working man's professional pedal board. Like, there is no space here. Like, oh, see, again, you have the same thing that Justin has, the Voodoo pedal power supply that kind of, like, powers everything from the underside of it.
Yeah, exactly.
And, yeah.
Oh, I forgot to talk about that. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, I mean, power, we'll talk more about that.
Oh, but and another modification I did to my board, it's, it has a connection for the power here. The out, you know, the power out, and it has an outlet for, is that what you call it, an outlet?
Yeah.
To plug just another, maybe like another pedal or an extension cord right here in the front of it. And but I found that I needed to hire the stuff I'm connecting to that one.
Yeah, sure.
So I ended up running a how do you call it when the wires are like, you're going to edit this
like part. An angled? Thing or what?
Yeah, like a right angle. Thank you.
Right
angle. A right angle extension cord.
Okay.
And I put that here, and then I made a hole on the inside of the board, and I run it inside. So now I have a
craftsman as well. it's amazing.
But yeah. So anyways, now I can power my pedals that require to be connected directly to the AC power. It's on the underneath.
Very cool. And what you can't see is Bose L1.
Yeah.
With the unit here. Awesome sounding.
Life. Yeah, I'm using the Bose L1.
Yeah, so
amazing.
Let's get you going, man. I want you to do a demonstration of doing things. And yeah, also, too, definitely check out his channel. I'm going to link you to his channel. He's got a lot of cool stuff going on. I think you're maybe going to do some more in-depth pedal stuff.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Yeah, I've been doing videos for a while, but I'm about to do way more videos. So
he'll always be around.
Yeah, come over.
Spread
check it out.
Up, man.
I hope you like my music, you know. I've been playing for a very long time, and I've been writing my own music, so check it out, you know. Check it out. I'm going to play an original song right now. So.
All right, here it is, Andreas Colleen.
So basically, I make sure I have the rhythm that I want to, you know, the speed and the cadence of the rhythm I'm going to be playing, because this is my main loop. Everything will be built upon this one. Is the first stone right here. And that's recorded. Now I'm gonna record the shaker. So I click on the AB switch and the microphone goes now to the loop. That's why my voice is now different. I have a little bit of bongos or congas here. Bass. Mirarte cuando rías, voy a hacerte melodías. Y cuando estés desesperada, me voy a atar a tu mirada. Escucharé lo que me digas mientras te vayas siendo mía. Voy a saciarte de mis besos y a liberar tus labios presos. Basically, I can actually erase the last loop. The last loop was the bass. I'm gonna erase that so I can go into the chorus.
No vayas a preguntar qué habrá después, qué seguirá. No te preocupes tú, mi vida, mejor acércate más. Yo te prometo no soy malo, nunca te haré llorar. Solo disfruta este momento, que esta vida se va a acabar. Now I'm gonna double click this effect here, check it out.